Are you all right, Stu?
Yeah. It's not me. I think it's Harold. Something's happened to him.
Go out on me, Bobby Terry.
Jan.
Dunabar!
Post 9, if you can hear me, come on back.
That's Henry.
I know it is! I'm right here, Mr. Henry, but we haven't seen anything yet. Not a single vehicle.
Well, keep your eyes open. And remember what I told you. Don't mark him.
Right. I mean, copy.
Just remember it. We want all the people over there to know exactly who they're looking at. So stay alert.
Well, roger that.
Man.
Black powder were brains. That guy couldn't blow his nose.
Lloyd, are you coming back?
Oh, yeah. Sleep.
I might need a sleeping pill.
Call me the doctor.
Sausage brain, you know that?
You're just a sore loser.
That was him! Come on, he's getting away!
Remember, in the guts, he wants his head.
Man, when I hit him with this, won't be nothing left but the head.
Shoot an unarmed man now, would you, old-timer?
Were you back at Copperfield?
Yep, we seen you go by. Dave Roberts.
Oh, God! You bastard!
Get him dead on, Dave!
Shut the hell up.
Here's Lloyd. Come on back.
The judge is awash.
What?
Awash. Awash. A total washout! You copy, you idiot?
Yeah, copy.
It's time to take their number two.
You know who it is?
I've known all along, actually.
Listen to me, Lloyd. Listen to me very carefully, soldier.
Wake up! Come here. Get dressed, you lying spine bitch.
Lloyd, you have seen me naked for the last time in your short, miserable life. I'm going in there. And if you even try and stop me, I will do my very best to give you a sex change operation. Excuse me.
Let her go. Let her go. She tries to lock the door, break it down.
You do know that I faked it every time, don't you, Lloyd? With you, Lloyd, for fun. Do you people know what your tin god is up to? What is it that you think that they're doing out there at Indian Springs?
Hey! You're not out of there in 30 seconds. You can give your sermon a flag in your panties.
Says frog, you jump. Isn't that the way it goes?
He's the biggest and the strongest, man.
You're wrong, and you're a fool.
Come on.
I've got her RF.
RF, how perfect.
Send her in, please.
Dana. Hi, come in.
You expected Charles Manson at the very least, didn't you?
I don't know what I expected. Lloyd.
Poor Lloyd had a very bitter experience in Phoenix not long ago. It marked him. Sit down, Dana.
What happened to the chairs?
Oh, I had them taken out. Liars sit in chairs, you know. Truth tellers just sort of hunker down. Your friends in Boulder sent you to spy out the land, true?
I suppose.
You, the judge, and someone else. I can't quite see this third person. Sometimes, usually, in fact, I can figure these things out for myself. I'm one of those lucky people with a little psychic twinkle. But every time I try to see this third spy, all I can see is the moon.
M-O-O-N. That spells moon.
Does that mean anything to you, Dana?
Not a thing. What about the judge?
Oh, never mind the judge. Now pay attention, dear. I'm disposed to give you your things and send you back to your friends in Boulder. And when you get back, I'd simply like you to tell them for me that we are just trying to get on our feet again, as they are. That we mean them no harm.
Then what's Carl Huff and that weirdo trash can man doing out at Indian Springs? Are you planning to turn the missiles stockpiled out there into New Age water fountains or something?
Never mind the trash can, man. Let it go, dear. There's no reason to hang on to this spy business. Your old black witch is dead. Your people are in confusion. If there was ever any reason for your being here, it's gone.
Mother Abigail is not dead.
Oh. I'm afraid she is.
I don't believe it.
She died in a coma, without saying a word. Well, that's it, dear.
You mean I can just go?
Oh, there is one more thing.
What's that?
The moon man. Who is he?
I don't know.
I think you do.
No, really, I don't know. I didn't even know about the judge until I heard Lloyd talking about him with some guy in Idaho.
That makes perfect sense. But all the same, you do know. You know, and you'll tell me. Do you understand?
Why don't you know? Why don't you know already?
I don't know. Tell me, you bitch! Tell me!
Hey!
Oh, my dear.
You'll tell me what I want to know. Before I'm through with you, you're bad to tell me.
Come back when the moon is full.
When the moon is full. M-O-O-N. It spells moon.
Watch out, would you?
What is it, Stu?
It's Harold. He's dead. I don't know how I know or why, but he's dead. He blew his own head off. Gun oil. My mouth's full of the taste. May God have mercy on this poor excuse for his soul.
Hey, Trek, what did old lady Semple say when you torched her pension check?
People who play with fire wet the bed, Trash.
Shut up, old lady Semple, and leave me alone!
Ew! Keep him away from me!
I'm gonna stick you in the nut hatch up and tear a hoax, Trash. Stick you in the nut hatch and give you a few thousand shock treatments.
No!
Crash! Hey, Crash! I've been looking for you everywhere!
Damn firebug. I don't trust him. Wait a minute. Wait just one damn minute.
Oh my God, no!
Nadine. Over here. Over here, my love. That's right. This way.
Come to make a fuss or pick a fight.
Just want you to tell me if you think you can, baby. Can you dig your man? He's a righteous man.
I bet you haven't been in this good of shape since you was a kid.
About 100 years ago, right?
Come on. Yeah, there's a perfectly good reason for this little stroll, you know. And Mother Abigail knew it when she sent us out the way she did, with just the clothes on our backs. Our bellies are empty, and more importantly, our heads are empty.
Hell, mine was pretty empty to begin with.
Yeah, well, I'm serious. We're out here in the middle of the great American nowhere, minus all the baggage we used to carry every place we went. She wanted us cleaned out, empty, ready to be filled up again by some new thing. Maybe a great thing. Almost certainly the last thing.
Come on, Kojak. Fetch, boy. Go on, go get it. Go.
Important, you make sure that he knows it was me who told you, okay?
Okay,
me,
yeah.
Me,
I
me,
got
me,
it.
Me.
All right.
Me.
Sure. Boy.
All right, we can see you.
Thought we might see you last night.
Oh, well. You know how it is with newlyweds.
Listen, we haven't managed to pick trash up. We're concentrating in the desert west of Indian Springs, but it's big country out there, and it just might take a while.
He'll come back in on his own eventually. When he does, I want him put away, but mercifully. I doubt if you can understand this, but I felt a certain kinship for that boy. I don't want him to suffer.
Fine. I just thought...
Ooh. Such a rouge. Come, dear.
And this might be important. This girl thinks she saw something.
Later, later, later. Come up this afternoon. 1 o'clock should be fine. In the meantime,
she's crazy about me, Lloyd. She can't get enough.
Leave a bye-bye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
We are dead, and this is hell.
Baby, can you dig your man? He's a righteous man. Tell me, baby, can you dig your man? Can you get that, sweetie pie? Ooh, I guess not.
Oi. Come in. Come in. I don't believe I've introduced my wife to you by name.
No.
Nadine. I'd like you to meet Lloyd Henreid, my number one soldier.
Pleased to meet you, ma'am.
Oh, no, no, no. Shake hands, kids. Shake it, Nadine. That's nice. You can put it down now, my love. My wife is indisposed. She also has a bun in the old oven. Perhaps the two are related. Care to gargle a little fire water, Lloyd? A libation to little Randy Jr.
Yeah, I'll have a gin and tonic.
The drink of champions. Make it two. You can sit down now, my love. I'm sorry, my dear. The Surgeon General says that pregnant women shouldn't drink. Or did before he died of the flu, right, Lloyd?
There are four men on their way here from Boulder. Strolling right up Route 73 for some mad reason, know them only to themselves and their dead witch. I want them bagged and I want them brought here. Send out Barry Dorgan. Dozen good men.
You want me to have some crosses made?
I think something slightly more inventive may be in order here. Natives seem restless, you know. What about that skinny little bat-faced girl downstairs? What's her itch?
Well, she thinks she spotted their third spy night before last. Says she saw him in Kansas in the company of a young deaf-mute male. I don't know, but this deaf-mute sure sounds like the one in their...
Upstairs without telling me, I could pop your neck like a dick. Maybe I should.
I tried to tell you, cut me off.
How's that drink, Lloyd?
Oh, it's great. It's all over the wall.
I gotta tell you something, Lloyd. For a guy who almost turned his cellmate into canapes, you got a yard of guts, you know that?
Thank you.
Doesn't he, Nadine? She says yes. This guy, the girl with the big hair, thinks she saw. What's his name?
Tom Cullen.
Probably doesn't matter much still. Send out 100 men. Put Russ Dorr in charge. Maybe they'll get lucky and stumble across him.
What about Trash? What do you want me to do about him?
Just remember, when he comes in, it's to be quick and painless.
Listen, RF, is everything all right?
Fine as fiddlesticks, why do you ask?
No, I just... Some of the folks are a little bit worried. I'm a little bit worried myself, to tell you the truth, so...
Everything's fine, Lloyd. Everything will continue to be fine as long as you remember who's the boss. And who's got the power. Right?
For you, you know. The old woman sent them before she died.
Get your ass back in here.
Everything you've made here is falling apart.
They're saying a simple retarded boy outwitted Randall Flagg. They're saying Judge Ferris got away from your man in Idaho.
He's as dead as Judas Iscariot.
They're asking questions about Dana, too. It's all slipping through your fingers. And they're whispering, Randy. I can see them leaving their posts in the dead of night, and your eye can't see them. And when they come here, Stu, and Ralph, and Glenn, and when they get here, your time will end, and I'll be watching. I'll be watching from hell with your baby in my arms.
Come back in, Nadine. I'll give you everything you could ever want.
Can you give me Larry again? Your seed is cold.
You lie! Fuck! No!
I'm staying right here.
Do you hear me?
Right here.
Get me out of here, Whit. Walls have ears, huh? So?
Me and some of the others are cutting loose. Man, I must be crazy telling you this.
It's all right. Cut loose where?
South America. Near Rio. Jenny's been there and she says it's nice. Fresh water, fresh fruit, ocean air, and just plain folks. Ones who want to forget they ever hooked up with his infernal majesty. So what do you say?
Me? I'm sticking.
Why? It's going bad here, can't you feel it?
Maybe. But he saved me from starving to death. And that's not even the main thing, I mean... He changed me, you know? And he trusted me. So yeah, I'm sticking.
Man, you're nuts.
You're probably right.
You know, I thought there'd be whores. I haven't seen any whores.
Man, don't even want you to have a drink. And dope. Forget about it. I've been thinking. I might not go back to Vegas at all. Mexico ain't but 300 miles in that direction.
What was that?
They're just a deer. They're all over.
Maybe we should go look.
Go ahead. Why should I be out there wandering around in the dark? Maybe break my leg for that freaking cowboy boots.
You ought to watch it, Rich. Man has a way of hearing things, seeing things.
Well, a flag don't scare me. Billy, toss me another. I gotta sit out here and freak my foot out.
M-O-O-N. It spells moon.
Utah State Highway Department about this.
Must have been a flash flood. A damn mess.
Think you can make it, Glenn?
I think so. Now, what do you think, Kojai? Whoa!
Yeah! Yeah! Woo!
Won't any of us do better than that, huh? Well, here goes.
It's not any better. Okay, so who's first now?
I'll go. You guys wait till I'm all the way up.
Be careful.
Piece of cake.
You see? I told you! Piece of cake!
Go!
Oh my God! Easy! Oh, I snapped my head. This way. My God. Ah! Ow!
Just don't move. Don't move.
Right leg!
Don't move. Ah!
That's a good way to kill yourself, Bateman.
soda.
Tour bus. About a quarter of a mile west of here.
Thanks.
They had beer, too. But I didn't want you taking these with alcohol. I brought them with me for my arthritis. Down the hatch.
Ralph and I'll go next time, Glenn. Stay here with Stu and rest up.
Go where?
We gotta make you some kind of stretcher. Get you out of here. Hole up someplace. I think Green River to be best.
No, Larry. I'm not going.
What are you talking about?
I'm saying no. No trip to Green River, no stretcher. It's against the rules of the game.
This is no game, Stu.
Stu's right, Larry. Mother Abigail said one of us would fall by the way.
What does that mean? Huh? What are you saying? You're a college professor, for God's sakes.
Not anymore. In case you hadn't noticed, Larry, school is out.
Look, I thought he was your friend!
Of course he's my friend. But that doesn't matter now.
It's God's plan.
Shut up about God. I'm sick of hearing about God.
This whole trip was based on the idea that Mother Abigail knew what she was talking about.
That's right.
It's not right. It's not right. This isn't God's will or God's plan. It's a washout. And you got a broken leg, Stu, and I'm not going to leave you here.
Larry, listen.
What?
Listen.
Listen.
When we came on this trip, we put our lives in the hands of Mother Abigail's God. Now, that hasn't changed. If he wants me to eat, he'll send food. If he wants me to drink, he'll send rain. It's his business. Yours is to go against flag. Now, you got to do that. You got to go without me.
Do you know how crazy that sounds? Do you know how totally damn crazy that sounds?
Kojak, come on, boy.
Come on, boy. You better come back and get him.
Mother also used to say, all things serve the will of God. Maybe that goes for big dumb dogs, too. Take good care of him, East Texas.
Thank you.
dog, Kojak. That's a good boy. Well, do you want this? I guess it's about that time, isn't it? Boy, looks like I'm gonna die of the flu after all. That's pretty funny when you think about it. Here, boy. Go on, I lost my appetite. Go on.
So, here it is.
I will fear no evil.
I will fear no evil.
Let's go!
Hold your fire. Leg wants him taken alive.
Halt, right where you are.
Halt, he said.
How you doing?
Where's Stuart Redmond?
He met with a slight accident on the way here, Mr.
He's Paul Burleson, my first deputy. I'm Barry Dorgan, chief of Vegas security. What kind of an accident?
He stubbed his toe. Look, Mr. Drogan, Chief Dragon, Captain Drogan, whatever you want to call yourself, why don't we just get on with this?
All right, by virtue of the power vested in me, smartass, you're under arrest.
In whose name?
You know who I speak for.
Then why don't you say it? Well, I'll say it for you. He calls himself Randall Flagg, but who he really is an apostate of hell. Now, you got that on your little clipboard there, Mr. Burleson?
I wonder if you men might give me your social security numbers.
All right, I want them split up. Take Laughing Boy and the old man, put him in the back of my car. Take Farmer John, put him in the back of yours, Ace.
Yo. Come on. Come on! Relax. You don't need those. That's why we came here. We got a message for your little tin god.
Tin god? Tin god. Man, that's funny. I spent 22 years on the Santa Monica PD. And I know what happens when guys like you end up running the show. We haven't got a single addict in Vegas. Can your people say the same?
Mr. Dorgan,
even a man of your apparently limited intelligence should be able to see that your experiences with a few battered babies and drug abusers doesn't justify your embrace of a monster.
Well, that's great. Very good. You get the Rodney King Humanitarian Award for the day, Pat.
It's almost over for them now, Larry. Can you feel it?
I can feel it.
All right, never mind the cuffs. Just get them in the cars. Now. Now, move!
Mm-hmm.
quite a piece of work, Mr. Cockroach. We could take a lesson from you, especially in light of recent events. I have an idea that I'll be gone come this time tomorrow. But you'll still be trucking, won't you? Running your little roach errands.
It's a wrap on the roach.
Randall Flagg. And not half the boogeyman we expected.
I'd like you to meet my associate, Mr. Lloyd Henry. Lloyd, meet Mr. Glenn Bateman.
Pleased to meet you.
How's that arthritis, Glenn? May I call you Glenn? It looks painful. I could fix that. Would you like me to? No more swollen, screaming joints for the rest of your life? All you have to do is ask.
What a deal.
Just ask. Ask me to relieve your pain.
It's not so bad, really. And as for the rest of my life, how long might that be anyway? 6 hours? 12?
Actually, I've decided to let you go.
Really? Marvelous. Of course I couldn't go without my friends.
Oh, of course not. No, you'll all go together. Tomorrow morning. Tonight, if you prefer. And, once again, all you have to do is ask. Only, for a favor of this magnitude, I really think you ought to do it on your knees.
Stop it.
Stop laughing at me.
Sorry, it's just that we made such a business of you. And it turns out you're nothing more than another cockroach scurrying around, running little roach errands.
Shoot him.
What?
You heard me.
Shoot him, you idiot! Shoot him!
He's an old man.
Can't you do anything right? He's standing right in front of you!
If you really feel you must shoot somebody, Mr. Henry, I suggest Flagg. His world is crumbling, and we both know it. I think we also both know he can do a lot of damage on his way down. You could change that.
We'll shoot one of us anyway. I'm the one who got you out of jail when you were starving. Those guys like him that put you in, that let the superflu loose in the first place, for that matter. But you choose, Lloyd.
He lies, Mr. Henry. You know that, don't you?
Mister, he told me more truth than anyone else in my whole lousy life.
It's all right, Mr. Henry. Don't know any better.
Shut up, you mouthy old bastard!
Think they just...
Yeah, I do. Our father. Who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth.
hold a pale horse, and him who rode upon it was death. You must see what's coming, Stuart, and take back such news as will never be forgotten. Now wake up. Wake up!
I can't, Mother. I can't, Mother.
Wake up!
I can't. I got to get up there.
Dreams, Stu. Isn't that the limit?
Yeah, Tommy. That's the limit.
Are you sick? Well, you sound sick. Laws, yes.
Oh, it's a flu, Tommy. Ain't that a bitch?
I gotta get you inside somewhere.
No, not yet.
Why not, Stu?
I don't know. But I think we're gonna find out soon, though. Okay. You just wait. You just wait here.
Yet to kill Glenn. He tried to escape. You know, one of these days you're gonna get shot trying to escape, Dorgan. You too, Ratty.
Yeah. One less rat man in the world.
Shut up, that honky voodoo.
Don't be an ass!
What is that?
You're gonna see. So enough.
Black can do that.
Unless he shows, they'll take him if they want him.
Here you go, Gravy. Play a little traveling music, go Gravy. You going? You gonna be traveling, I guarantee.
Keep back!
Keep back!
Keep back! Get out of the way.
They're moving any closer. Throw a few heads on.
Hey, ain't you famous? Now I'm famous too.
I'm trying. If I could just think about my mother.
Put the cuffs on!
You think that scares me, Dorgan? At this point, a shot in the head looks pretty good to me.
Don't make this harder than it has to be.
You think I could do that? Tell me something, Chief. They teach you this one at Santa Monica PD? Huh?
Sight of God.
I will fear no evil.
Ooh. Listen to me! All of you! I don't expect you to stop this, but you better remember what you see here tonight. Because the next time, it may be your turn to die this way.
Finished, Mr. Underwood?
You're the ones finished.
I take that as a yes. I, Randall Flagg, do hereby state that
Why don't you tell him your real name?
Do hereby state that these men are the insurrectionists responsible for the destruction of our unarmed scout planes at Indian Springs and for the murder of Carl Huff. For these crimes, they are sentenced to death by dismemberment. It is the duty of each of you to witness his punishment. However, those of you with small children are excused.
Take it, Perry.
Hey, you people! This ain't how Americans act! We gotta stop this! We gotta stop this!
Whitney. You should have kept still. I would have let you go. Why would I want to keep a jellyfish like you around anyway? Sort of gives a whole new meaning to the phrase, my lips are sealed, doesn't it, Whitney?
Diabola! Diabola! Bumpty, bumpty, bump! The fire for you! The big one for you! The big one for you! Bumpty, bumpty, bump!
God. It's a bomb!
trash.
Hey, Lloyd. I can't see very well. My eyes are all funny.
It's me, Trashy. What do you have there?
The big one. The fire. The A-bomb. The fire for you!
Listen to me, Trash. You have to get that away. It's dangerous.
Come back! Come back, you cowards!
Shoot him, boy. Kill the crazy bastard!
Kept as God has willed it. Amen.
Larry! Do you see it?
The hand of God.
Get away! Fire! Fire!
For you! Basin.
Done good, boys. Come on home.
Take us home.
I saw a pale horse, a pale rider upon it. The name of the horse was Pestilence. The name of the rider was Death.
What was it, Stu?
It's the end of Las Vegas, Tommy. And the end of Randall Flagg. If God is good.
What about Glenn and Larry? What about Ral?
You ready, Tom?
Okay.
Oh, please, God. Just a little help.
Okay, let's give it a try. Okay, hop in. Come on.
Okay.
Okay, here goes. All right.
Is it gonna be okay, Stu? Is it gonna be okay?
Yeah. I think maybe we just caught us a break.
Jelly. My mom always made it for me when I was feeling poorly. Always perked me up. Stu, please eat, Stu. You gotta eat. Stu. Stu, if you don't eat, you'll die. I'll be alone, Stu. You gotta eat for me, Stu. Please, too. Don't die.
Tom?
Is it really you? Stu said you were dead.
Stu's very sick, you know.
I know. He's got the flu. I tried to feed him like my mama used to, but he wouldn't eat. I'm scared, Nick.
It's all right. I know what to do.
This will make you better. Blush, yes.
How'd you know to get this stuff, Tommy?
Nick told me. In my dreams, she can talk. Did I ever tell you that?
Yeah. I think you did.
Tom? Hey. Tommy, what's wrong?
Can't remember what Nick looked like anymore. He's the best friend I ever had. Gave me a bike. He's always good to me. I can't remember him anymore. So stupid. I can't remember nothing.
Hey, there's a lot of important stuff you didn't forget. I'm still alive. I wouldn't be if it wasn't for you.
Really going home, Stu? Like Dorothy and the Wizard of Oz?
You bet. We're going home.
This is nuts, you know it? Won't be anybody else in here this winter. It is winter. It's early, but it is here. Now be careful. It could be Stu or it could be...
Hell, it could be anybody!
Hey! Who is it there?
You guys identify yourselves, and we're gonna shoot.
Stu!
Hey, Teddy.
Tom,
hey,
coming.
Bobby.
Man, I don't believe it. What happened to your leg, Stu?
I broke it. Never mind. We're frozen. Let's get in the truck. Then I want you to take me home to see Franny. What? Come on. What's wrong?
Stu.
What is it?
I don't exactly know how to tell you this, Stu.
What? What is it?
Well, it's the baby. It's come early, and it's got the flu.
Starting all over again. But George says that there's no way of knowing if any of the babies are going to be immune.
Let's not think about that now, Franny.
I can't help it. I have this big black hole in the middle of me. I can't help thinking, what did we all do this for? Why?
You propose nothing in the sight of God. Us at least, you know.
I know.
Stu, I can't tell you how glad I am to see you. How glad all of us are.
Hey, Doc.
The baby's dead, isn't it?
No, quite the opposite. I believe the crisis has passed.
You mean she's going to be all right?
Yes. I think the baby's going to live.
Oh!
The year one babies may not do as well as this one. But when both parents are immune, you will see the last of Captain Trips.
It's a miracle.
Yes, indeed. You got a beautiful daughter there, Fran. You take good care of her.
I will. Come back later.
Oh, no.
You're limping.
I hear you're pregnant.
Yeah.
Sure. Enjoy. Lucy. Larry.
No, I know. I know what happened. Sure that when the end came, they met it on their feet. And that's what they were sent out there to do, wasn't it? To stand.
I reckon it was.
He's gone. But I'll have his baby. Maybe it's not all I wanted or all I dreamed of having. But it'll have to be enough.
Thank you.
She's gonna be just fine. She's so beautiful.
No, I'm not crying for her. It's all of the others. All those empty cradles. Peek, baby.
Oh, oh. I know, honey, they're looking at the baby.
Ain't you beautiful? Just as gorgeous as dawn and evening.
People can change. Do you think that's possible?
I don't know. I really don't know. Maybe she does.